of course, is the New Kids on the Block. And the New Kids on the Block actually are back on the block. They have a new CD. So we thought, in honor of the New Kids on the Block, today we'd play a little game. We've got a whole section right over in here of New Kids on the Block fans. Give us a shout. I hear they're among the most dedicated, shall we say? Among the most dedicated fans on the planet. So we decided we would play a little game called Who's the Number One New Kids on the Block Fan? So we are going to get confessions about their obsessions. We've narrowed it down to the top three. They're right here in the front row. Audience, you are going to listen to the obsessed and then decide which confession warrants the title Number One New Kids on the Block Fan. Simple as that. Okay, so we're going to begin with Angie. Angie, wave
right
it.
Here.
Hey, wave it out, Angie. So Angie is our first confession. Spill it.
Okay, Rachel. I don't know about these two women over here, but I am the New Kids on the Block ultimate fan. I've been a fan of the New Kids on the Block for 15 years now. And one time, my friends and I got to spend the night at the hotel that the New Kids on the Block were staying. We had to literally sneak up to the floor they were at, and we knew what room they were in, and there was a room service tray there. Can you believe it? So I've kept all my room service for 15 years now. First of all, I have a spoon from Donnie Wahlberg's room.
Donnie licked that spoon!
And I have DNA!
Donnie DNA, lovely. Hi. And whose DNA do you have on the Mountain Spring water bottle?
This is Jordan Nathaniel Marcel Knight. Okay, Jordan is my favorite. This is his water bottle that I've kept all this time.
Oh, honey, hug it out. Are you okay?
I'm fine, Rachel. Okay, to make a long story short, I've had this for 15 years. Until yesterday, there was water in it. At the airport, they made me dump my water. I cried. I said, you don't realize how special this water is to me.
Oh, pumpkin.
I swear I need mental help.
Trying. Francis, you ready? You better embellish, because I don't know how you're topping that.
Oh, boy. Okay, I don't know about these two ladies, but I am the New Kids on the Block biggest fan. I have been a fan since I was 2 years old.
Two.
2 years old. I'm not lying. 2 years old. And I've loved them all these years. So, a couple of months ago, I turned 21. And instead of doing the normal things that 21-year-olds do are supposed to do on their birthday,
i.e. cocktail.
Yes. I decided that I would do something a little different. I decided to throw a New Kids on the Block birthday party. I had a cake.
Oh, God bless her.
I had a cake, pink and green balloons. I had the New Kids on the Block napkins, plates, everything. And instead of singing happy birthday to me, my family sang the right stuff.
That's sweet. Very sweet. And you even brought some of your memorabilia with you.
Okay, because Donnie, he's my favorite, he always has been, couldn't make it to my birthday party. I had to do something about that. See, since he wasn't able to give me a birthday kiss, I had to kiss my Donnie doll. And I will always be Donnie's cover girl.
That's lovely.
Always.
Oh, boy. That's quite a prop there. So now we're moving along to Kelly. Kelly, would you like to confess a little bit about your New Kids on the Block obsession?
Okay. I don't know about these two, but I have been Jordan Knight's biggest fan since I was 12 years old. Every night before bed, I would have to put in my tape, listen to the right stuff, and kiss him every night.
Is this from your actual bedroom?
Yes, at the foot of my bed.
So you've been kissing that for how many years now? Oh, my.
I'm 31 now, so.
And you've been kissing that?
No, only until I was 16.
Oh, I was going to say. You've been kissing that for close to 20 years now? That'd be a little scary. These are some good confessions. I think they all deserve a round of applause, don't you? But only one is going to leave with the contents of this little orange envelope. First of all, we have Angie with the water bottle. Yeah! Clearly, Angie is the one to beat. And then we have Francis with a 21-year-old New Kids on the Block birthday party making out with the Donnie doll. Not bad. Respectable. Respectable. I'm sorry, Francis, right? Francis was the middle one. Now we're going to go on to Kelly with the kissable, life-size, kissed it for 4 years every single night poster. Kelly, apparently there's a lot of poster kissing people here because they don't find that remarkable. I don't know, it's close between one and two, but I think we have to give it to poor Angie here, don't you think? So Angie, when I read what I have for you here in the little orange envelope.
Oh my God. Okay.
Why don't you guys give us a spin? I'm a little bored with the scenery over here. Come here, Angie. Come here, stand next to me.
Oh my gosh.
Up,
okay.
Angie, up. Come on over, Ange.
Okay, Rachel.
All right, so right here, I have two tickets for you to go see the New Kids on the Block. And, you know, this isn't here, actually, Ange. So okay. We're going to have to get you there. We're going to have to fly you to, where are you flying to? Los Angeles, California.
Oh, God!
Airfare and hotel. You can certainly try to get your water refilled because your friends are sitting at the table.
Next, it's time for the New Kids to come clean as we play a little true confession. Who would be the most likely to get a spray tan?
Oh, yeah.